Hello everyone, and welcome to today's session on Thoughts on Education with College Duniya. And today we have with us Dr. S.C. Kamate, who is the principal of HIT, that is Hirasagar Institute of Technology, which is in North Karnataka. And this is again a very interesting institution, which has its focus on giving more to the society, giving more to the students, wherein they are trying to, provide the students an education which is not just based on the core learnings of it, but also based on a holistic approach. And then they have a campus of 80 acres wherein they try to give you a life wherein in the next 4 years you live with nature, get a lot of fresh oxygen, and you live in a place where not just the core learnings, but also a holistic development is given a boost. Now, before I begin with the interview and before I go on to Dr. Kamate, I'll just give a small introduction about him so that you can also understand where how learned and how important a figure in this industry he is. So, Dr. Kamate has done his BE from Karnataka University, and then he has done his M.Tech and PhD from VTU, and his PhD is actually in the domain of thermal engineering. So, in fact, he teaches thermodynamics as well. So, apart from that, sir has a teaching experience of more than 28 to 29 years. And he has also been the Vice Chancellor's nominee for autonomous colleges like BEC Bagalkot and MIT Mangalore. And he's also been the head, the chairman and member of various committees for local inquiries as well as inspections of various colleges. So, welcome, sir. Welcome to this interview.
Thank you.
So, sir, there are some specific questions which I've understood that the students actually want to know from HIT and from you in general. So, I'll begin with those questions, and we'll try to, let's say, answer these questions as best as possible for the students to understand HIT in a short span of time.
Yeah, please proceed.
Okay, sir. So the very first question that I have recognized over here is that you've held a lot of key positions at educational institutions throughout your professional career. So what are the key factors that keep you connected to the education sector?
Yeah, I did not get your question.
Yeah. So, sir, what are the key factors which keep you connected to the education sector?
Yeah, it's basically interest in giving something good to society and for the welfare of the new generation to lead this nation. That has made me connected to this sector, and I have been involved in delivering my best quality and competency that has been bestowed to me by God, and trying to help the society and children for their holistic development.
Great. Okay. So that's very noble, sir. So I'll move on to the next question, which I've again seen a lot of students asking, which is that being the principal of HIT, what is your philosophy of leadership and how would you describe your leadership style?
Leadership by what you can say, front. I should be a soldier. You should not be just commander. You should be soldiers in by follow, or you can say frontline. You have to be leader by example, by your attitude, by your work, not by just teachings.
Okay. So leading by example is your take on leadership, and that is again very, very agreeable, sir. So, being the principal of HIT, how do you strategize upon the key programs and plans for the marketing and administration of your school?
Very interesting. I told you, even many platforms I shared this. Most of the times I go to 12th standard colleges and institutions and address the students. What should be their choice after 12th standard? How should they choose the career, whether it is engineering, medical or dental, whatever they wish to do. But we need to guide them, educate them and create an awareness among the students that they should not lead to a long choice this is what is the job I do and counsel them when I go to PUC colleges across the state. And I address the students. And one philosophy what I delivered when I address the students is, the choice of course or college should be based on the passion what they wish to do. It should not be influenced by the friends, or it should not be influence of anybody, whether it is a parent or it is a neighbor or anything. Most of the times the students do mistakes at third standard is they are influenced by the number one friends, number two parents, number three is the neighbors. How? I'll tell you some of the wrong examples also, and they end up with the wrong choice in college. My father or mother wanted me to become doctor. So I'm willing to take medical as my, choose medical sciences as my career. But I told the students that you assess yourself, that whether you have the passion of doing service to society, and service to mankind is service to God. That should be your attitude. Then you are going to be a very good doctor. Otherwise, after getting a gold medal from medical sciences institutions also, you cannot be a successful doctor. You might have been an excellent academic records, but if your attitudes are not towards service, serving the society, serving the patient, then your academic credence will not come to you. It will not be helpful to you. So basically, your choice should be based on your passion, not on the influencing parameters of your surrounding. If at all an engineering is going to be their career choice, then one should be very good in mathematics. Without having a sound mathematical base, if he or she makes a choice of engineering courses, he has to suffer a lot, and finally he cannot deliver the things also to society once he becomes an engineering graduate. So while choosing course or college, they must be very cautious and careful. Should not be influenced by anybody. The choice should be based on their passion of doing something. When they have a passion for doing something, certainly they'll be great doers and they will excel in their chosen field of education. That is advice that I give to third standard students.
Okay. All right, sir. So with this, let's move on to another important thing, wherein how does the curriculum of HIT ensure the best practices in the industry?
Very interesting question. Hirashugar Institute of Technology in Itsoshi is affiliated to Visveshwaraya Technological University. Being an affiliated college, we have a little flexibility in changing the curriculum or syllabus of the courses that we teach in the campus. We need to adhere to the guidelines and the curriculum issued by the university from time to time. But I hope Visveshwaraya Technological University is well-known and is well-read, well-graded and recognized by the across the country. So we have been following the syllabus of the Visveshwaraya Technological University and is one of the best in technical education. Of course, the curriculum may be however best, but ultimately it becomes successful only when it has been implemented very thoroughly and properly by competent teachers. So what I do assured here is every department has got a faculty having experience more than 15 years in their chosen fields of subjects. And those teachers have been teaching these subjects since last 15 years. So the expertise and the kind of depth and the richness in the subject content delivered at the classroom is absolutely much better than any of the institutions. That is one thing what we practice. Then second thing is there is a mentoring system in the college. Every teacher is given 10 students to mentor them properly of their academic progress. It is mentoring is not only monitoring their academic progress, even they should act like a parents in the campus. Even the health issues, any the personal problems of any students, they will address and they will do counseling for time to time requirements. So that is how the mentoring system works effectively, and that takes care of the students' welfare in the campus. That is a very effective way of, you can say, delivering the academics. Then the third thing, when it comes to facility, it's almost a 25 years old college, well-established structures are there. We do not have to add anything. Everything is available. What is that is, students have to use it very properly.
Okay, great, sir. I mean, very, very, very interesting and very fruitful for the students as well. The way you've talked about the mentoring process of teachers, I think it's very innovative and it's very effective. It would be giving very good results, very good benefits to the students. So let's move on to this another question, which is that any insights if you can provide on your college, how it could be more welcoming to different students from various races and various economic backgrounds. I mean, if you can shed some light on it.
Well, the college is 25-year-old established college, accredited at A grade by NAC, and all the engineering programs are accredited by National Board of Accreditation, NBA. It is only the one college, the 100% programs of the colleges are accredited by NBA. And this is as far as the academic credentials are concerned. Then the college admissions are open to all kind of class of people, men, women, all class, grade, irrespective of, there is no restrictions on admission to any of the students. It is open to everybody, and the fees are very, very nominal fees. That is as prescribed by the government of Karnataka from time to time. We are not charging any single rupee more than the prescribed fee by the government. That is the only institution in professional education where we adhere strictly to the guidelines of the government of Karnataka and fee fixation committee of the Karnataka government. This is how the admission process, and it attracts the students.
Okay, sir. So what do you think should be the priority of the college in the next coming 10 years?
I believe by another down 3 to 5 years, this will reach a state of university status.
Okay.
Because we are all working on that line. We have got all the eligibility to become university or to become an autonomous college under Visveshwaraya Technological University. But forward-looking vision for this institution has been already, you can say, blueprint for this institution has been already ready. We are working on making it as a state university. Shortly, we may come out with the decisions. And once it becomes a university, I believe is one of the most highly reputed university run by a philanthropist. And this university is going to be run by a great saint with great passion for giving something back to society and having no profit making in interest in the transactions. That is going to be a very special future of this institution.
Okay, sir. I wish and I hope that you do get the accreditation of a university, and you do get through the process, and because we would all like to see such a university doing well, because you are giving a lot to the society, and that is very important. So let's move on to the next question over here, sir, wherein when you first came to HIT, what was your vision for the college, and how far along are you in implementing the vision, and has this vision also evolved with time?
Yeah, almost 5 years back, I took charge of this institution as a principal. And when I have been given the responsibility of leading this institution, basically I looked at two things. One is how best the quality standards can be brought into the system and delivered to systems. that is improving teaching learning processes. And second thing is reaching the students community. Putting the idea on paper is one thing, and implementing it is another challenging issue. Because any ideas you work out, that when it goes for implementation, you require competent people to deliver it. So we have started the process of identification of eminent persons in the field of their expertise. This is how the whole journey began. And by down 5 years, we were able to identify almost 15 to 20 doctorates in different streams of specialization, where you call it as electrical engineering, or you call it as antennas, microwaves, or thermal stains, material science, applied chemistry. So almost 15 to 20 doctorates in engineering, and with highly reputed institutions, right from Indian Institute of Science to IITs. The professors have been brought down here, and they are all working very, very friendly and very cooperatively with me. This is how I was able to take these institutions from the present state of affairs to A-grade institutions in the country, accreditation, getting an accreditation standard by NAC, and getting all the engineering programs accredited by the National Board of Accreditation. Otherwise, they think the national benchmarks cannot be satisfied.
Okay.
Now the objective in front of me is what should be the next level of growth. So now we are all eligible for becoming an autonomous college or becoming an independent university. UGC has made it very clear that any institutions having CGPA score more than 3 or 3.1 are eligible to get the autonomous status by UGC, University Grants Commission. So we already fit into those clauses. We are working. The blueprint is already ready. Things, I hope, will come shortly, materialize, and we'll be able to emerge as one of the state private university or any other universities. And we look forward for expanding its programs and reaching, giving a very cost-effective education to rural, particularly rural masses.
Okay, right. So, sir, are there any specific, points which you would like to highlight for people? I mean, some things about the college which people might not know and you want to highlight it to them?
Yeah,
including the strengths as well.
The basic features of this college are, though this college is located in a rural area, this has been spread on 80 acres green campus, which has been filled with lot of birds, animals, you can say peacocks, the deer, everything you will find in the campus, a lake, then so many things you will be able to enjoy in the campus. And the hostels are wide scattered so that everybody gets sufficient space and air, breathing, walking spaces, pathways, everything. And food is a very attractive component of this institution. Every student, every hostel of 300 capacity has been built. And every hostel has got different messes, and they are managed by the students itself. Almost they get two meals and one time tiffin and two times tea, all inclusive. They get around 52 to 55 rupees per day. That is a very cost effective way of delivering quality food to students. And the life in campus is very peaceful. They are away from the urban disturbances. They are away from the population density related issues like COVID or any the contagious diseases or vehicle pollution, traffic jam. This everything is there away. It is like a pure, you can say, a complete gurukula system of education that they can look forward. Only they have to do is sit and read, and study, get a good percentage of marks and come out as a complete personality from this institution. And the third interesting point is, almost weekly, the Mahaswamiji of this institution, the president, is a great saint of 78 years old. He visits the campuses, he advises the students on a lot on the philosophy, ethics, and other components of education. That is a great differentiating factor. One will get it. Otherwise, you may get engineering education even much better than this institution also. But this kind of making complete man is only, I believe, this institution will have this facility. Many times parents also report the same thing. Swamiji, whether my son or daughter learns engineering is secondary, but at least he learns how to fold his hands and bow his head when the parents come or the seniors come to in front of them. That is a kind of culture they learn in the campus.
Right. And it's very important as well, sir, not just staying connected to education, but also staying connected to your culture, your society, every one of these things. So now that we've talked about your strengths and, you know, the things that you want people to know, is there any suggestion that you would like to give to the current and the aspiring youth for your college and in general for any student who wants to go for engineering or anything else?
I have already spoken on these issues just a few minutes also, but still I, an extension of that, choose your college and course by passion, not by influence. Because one thing is very thing, because my friend has chosen this X college or Y college, I am also going for that college and that course. That should not be the attitude of the students. Your friend has an interest in that, he has chosen. You just assess yourself whether you have that interest or not. Then you select a course and college. Certainly you will be a successful personality when you come out from this education system.
Okay. All right, sir. So with that note, I'll move on towards the last question that I have over here for you, which is that how do you tend to establish a healthy relation and environment in your college?
That is what I told you already. Mentoring system is a basic mechanism that keeps everybody connected. Every teacher has been allocated 10 students. Their all movements will be monitored very closely. Whether it is a ragging activity, or it is a food problem, or it is a health issue, or it is his attendance, or his academics, everything will be monitored on a weekly basis, and that will be reported to me. In case of any exigency or emergency, I will be intervening and resolving the issues. If I am also not able to do that, then the parents will be called to campus and the things will be sorted out. That is how very effectively this takes place. And even a small incident also not reported so far in last 5 years I've been looking because of this mechanism.
Wonderful, sir. That is very great. And I think most of the queries and the doubts that students had regarding HIT before admissions, I think they would have been answered with all of these detailed answers that you gave to our questions. So I'd like to, you know, towards the end, I'd like to first of all thank you for this insightful and informative session that you've had with us, because we've gotten to understand HIT post this session in a much more better manner, and in a better, you know, not just about HIT, but in general how we need to proceed towards education. We have a better understanding now. And I would also like to thank you from, you know, the side of the students who would actually find this session to be quite helpful. The general students for all streams and all educational institutions in general who are going to watch this video, and for especially those students who are actually going to look forward to getting admitted in HIT this year itself. So I would like to thank you from their side, and I really wish you luck and safety, and I wish that you achieve all of those things that you you said that you want to achieve with the HIT, sir. I mean, be it converting HIT into university, or be it trying to achieve all of those things with the students that you're trying to. I really wish you luck and achievement in these, and I wish that you and your entire family of HIT stays safe in these hard times of COVID, which the entire society is getting troubled with right now. And I really hope that you stay safe and you stay lucky.
I thank the College Dunya platform for sharing, giving me an opportunity to share this platform and pass my personal or in the capacity of principal of this institution, share my thoughts with the prospering students who are taking admission to various courses. Before concluding, I would like to pass a message to students. You choose any course or college, before making any choice, have complete survey and knowledge of that college and the course and the potentials, job prospects, and the quality of education that is delivered, and the care that institution is taking for you during your stay in the campus. Then you take a decisions, not just get influenced by parents, friends, or neighbors and jump into admissions without knowing any credentials of these institutions. The two important credentials you look for any institution to be chosen is, one, you see whether institutions is accredited either by NAC or by National Board of Accreditation. Second, interesting thing is you see how well you are placed in the placement in the sense, I'm not talking of the placement or job, how well you have been taken care in the campus, your food, your health, your stay. Because nowadays the days are very sensitive, our priority should be not on job and placements, our priority should be on the health, and the next comes everything. So you look how the education has been given holistically in the institutions and take your decisions. That is what I can advise to my young friends who are eager to come out of present positions and come into degree colleges. I wish them everybody a very, very prosperous career in their chosen field of choices. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much, sir. I hope that you keep leading by example like this, and I hope that you keep helping students and following their passion. And thank you so much for this session, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.